62. We are just about ready for baseball from Dodger Stadium in Los Angeles. Tonight, it's an in-division matchup from the NL West between the San Francisco Giants and the Los Angeles Dodgers. We've got baseball on the show, and it's coming up next. Tony Gonsolin is on the mound for the Dodgers in this contest. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, it's hard to have all four of your pitches on, but I think if this guy can have two or three of his four pitches and have command of them, he's going to have a really good game.
Wade Lamont Jr., the batter, and we are set for baseball here this evening. The 1-2 is swung on and missed, strike three. That was a nasty looking slider that time.
Yeah, that was really well executed, Matt. A classic strikeout pitch. You think it's fastball middle in, then it starts bearing in on your back leg, and unless you hit it out front, there's nothing much you can do with that.
Stepping in now, Mike Yastrzemski. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Expected to get a little cooler as we go on, but the temperature at game time, 68 degrees. And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. One out, nobody on. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
The main job of the number one and two hitters is to set the middle of the order up with an opportunity to do some damage. So when you strike both of them out, you're putting yourself in a pretty good position to make it through the teeth of the lineup without a whole lot of stress.
So now to the plate, Buster Posey. Two balls and two strikes to the Giants catcher.
They teach pitchers to keep the ball down, but if you can locate upstairs like that, it really gives you the ability to mess with the eye level of the batter.
Hard on the ground towards short. He's got it. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Giants down in order. It's the Giants nothing. Dodgers coming to bat. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Alex Wood will be the man on the mound for the G-men. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, this guy has a four-pitch repertoire, right? And those are a lot of nice options to have. You can go hard, soft. You can go in and out. And anytime you have four pitches, if you can throw them for strikes, you have the big advantage.
Now at the plate here is Mookie Betts. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-1 fouled off. Here comes the 1-2. Swung on in the dirt, strike three. And the throw is there to record the first out. Next for the Dodgers, Justin Turner. Bases are empty, one man out. This one's down to third. Flores is there. In time to first, and there are two away.
Batting third, the center fielder, Cody Bellinger.
Next up for Los Angeles, Cody Bellinger. First cuts for him here with the bases open and two away. Wood gets the sign. Here's the 2-1. Lifted the other way out to left center. And he will make the catch just shy of the track, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. Still no score. And that'll bring up the big bat of Alex Dickerson. He'll get us started in the top of the second. Now the 2-1.
To be honest with you, I'm a little bit more afraid of the guy on deck than the guy that's up right now. If I'm on the mound, I want this guy up right now. He's the guy that's got to beat me.
Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. And it's fouled away. The payoff pitch one more time. Into center field, line drive, base hit.
I'm sure the boys on the bench appreciate that AB right there. Grinded out an 8-pitch at bat and was able to be successful and deliver a hit for the team.
Into the box now, Brandon Crawford. Now here's a fly ball, well hit. Betts looking up, and that ball will stay fair, and it's gone, a home run. So a 2-run homer down the line in right field as the Giants have taken a 2-0 lead.
Hey, that's the price you pay right there when you try and sneak a fastball past this guy. Power hitter, and every power hitter in the league knows you got to start with the numero uno, number one, man. You got to get on the heater and adjust to everything else, and he did just that.
In now, Wilmer Flores. Now a swing, and the barrel of the bat breaks in two that time. And he'll steer clear of the flying debris to make the catch here for the first out.
Donovan Solano.
Next to bat for the Giants, Donovan Solano, last year's recipient of the Silver Slugger Award for NL second baseman. Slapped hard the opposite way, and that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. And time will be called here as the pitching coach heads out to the mound and hopefully try and settle this guy down a bit. At the plate now, Steven Duggar. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. Do you think you can drive it? But it's really hard to get on top of that good, high, hard fastball.
A ball and two strikes to the Giants pitcher. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. Bye bye, baby. The Giants strike for a pair as you get another look at the 2-run dinger. On to the bottom of inning number two. It's now 2-0 San Francisco. Leading off the inning, it'll be Will Smith as they'll look to spark the offense and even things up.
You know, these next couple innings are really important for these guys. I know they're only down by a couple, but they need to get something going on offense to keep pace, even though it's early.
Count is 1-2 now. Lifted in the air to center field. Duggar is there, and he makes the catch for the out.
Batting fifth, the first baseman, Mass. Muncy.
Digging in next, Max Muncy. Now the 2-1. Hit hard, but right into the shift. And that's the second out. Next to hit, Chris Taylor. Lifetime history with Alex Wood. He's 1-for-3. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Two out, nobody on. And it misses. 3-1 now.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
And this one misses inside. A ball he walked him, and they've got themselves a two-out base runner.
Man, the pitcher's wondering how he didn't get that call. Busted him inside on a 3-1 count, and the ump thought it was just a tad off the plate. Tough to get the benefit of the doubt from the umpire when you fall behind in a count like that, though.
Wood sets. Here's the 1-1. That nibbled the corner there, but missed. 2-1. Taylor is off a first with two away. Below the zone, a swing and a miss.
Hey, I'd like to see a little bit more discipline in that. You get a count in your favor, and you swing at a pitch that bad? Not good.
2-2, here it is. This one misses, and that'll fill the count here. 3-2 with two away.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls.
We knew coming into this game that this guy has a tendency to give up a lot of free passes, and history repeats itself as he's already given up two walks here. I'll tell you, effectively wild is a pretty tough thing to be.
And now, A.J. Pollock. Two's all over the place. Two on, two out, and of course, here in inning number two. Now the 2-1 pitch is offered at and missed. He chased it for strike two.
I'm going to need to see a better game plan out of the hitter right here. That ball was at his eyes.
There's a breaking ball that couldn't quite catch the inside.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. Couple of walks in the inning, but nothing on the scoreboard. We'll come right back with more from Dodger Stadium in just a moment. Top of the third set to get underway, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Lamont Wade. Now the 1-1 pitch is taken for strike two. Right side, but it's well foul. And this is swung on and missed. Five quick strikeouts now, and that's your first out of the inning.
Boy, there's nothing better from a pitcher standpoint than watching that high fastball, a high piece of cheese, swung at and missed. That pitch looks so inviting to hit, but it's awfully tough to put in play.
At the plate, Mike Yastrzemski. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Count still at 1-2. One out, nobody on. And a swing and a miss, and another punch out here. Six already, and that's out number two.
He's really on a roll right now on the mound. Back-to-back strikeouts to wrap up the last inning, and now he started this frame with the same story. Four straight strikeouts in all.
Into the box, Buster Posey. Hit in the air to shallow center. Bellinger's under it. And that's the third out. Giants are down 1-2-3, but they hold a 2-0 lead. Leading off the inning, it'll be Tony Gonsolin, and they could use a spark from him here. Dodgers pitcher trying to deal with a 1-2 count at the plate.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Tony Gonsolin is retired for the first out here in the bottom half of the third. The 2-1 on its way. Swing and a little tapper. This one for Crawford is short. Oh, and he overshoots his first baseman as it's over his head.
Wow, I know shortstops have the reputation for being flashy, and I think he was trying to show off his cannon of an arm on that one. But the cannon was a little too powerful, and the ball sails way over the first baseman's head. He did get a lot behind the throw, though.
To the plate now, Justin Turner. Now a swing and a fly ball. Right fielder giving chase, and no one will track it down. Betts, the runner at second with one away. Swing and a liner. It's down for extra bases, and the Dodgers have their first hit of the game. And the runner scores from second as they cut away into that deficit here. It's now a 2-1 ball game.
Nothing fires me up more than watching an offensive player stay inside a baseball and drive it the other way.
Cody Bellinger.
So now to the plate, Cody Bellinger. A good action on the two-seamer there, and it's 1-2.
Yeah, he just wasn't on time right there. Front foot not down in time. Nothing happens before the front foot can get down.
Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now.
Everyone in the ballpark knows what the pitcher's intentions are in this situation. Great job at the plate to lay off a tough pitch in a good spot.
The 2-2.
Looked like he was cheating a heater right there. A little bit too far out in front. Gotta find a way to keep his hands back.
Here's another 2-2. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. A man at third with one away. And he fouls this one off. Two and two count. Here it comes. Drilled to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
Now
so stepping in is Will Smith. A potential tying run for him at third base. A 1-2 pitch. Fouled away. Here's the 1-2. Grounder down the line at third. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Two and two to the Dodgers catcher.
Boy, his pitch count is really spiked here in this inning. He's up to over 50 already.
The set and the 2-2 fouled off. Keeps fighting him off. The eighth pitch of the at bat coming up. He stays alive, still 2-2. Here it is. And he struck him out, so he was forced to make 9 pitches that at-bat, but he'll take it as the inning is over. But they do get on the board in the inning on this run-scoring triple. We're through 3 here in Southern California, and this is now a 2-1 ball game. Welcome back to Dodger Stadium. Let's send it down to the field in Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. Between innings, I was able to discuss the current state of the Giants lineup with their manager, Gabe Kapler. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. It's still pretty early in the game, but they've seen a lot of pitches already. And he thinks the 2 runs they've pushed across so far is just the beginning, given the quality of the at-bats they're putting together.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. All set for the start of the 4th. And that'll bring up the outfielder, Alex Dickerson. Two and two.
Hey, that's the modern game right now. North, south. Elevate that high fastball and bury stuff in the dirt. Completely different from the east, west we came up playing.
Throw to first in time. 1 gone here in the 4th. Up next, Brandon Crawford. Off to a fine start in this one after launching a homer his first time up.
He turned around that fastball and drove it out of the park in his previous at-bat, so there's got to be a good chance they mix it up right here on him and try and go off speed.
On to first, and there were 2 down.
Now batter.
2 down, no one on base. And up next, the utility man, Wilmer Flores. A 2-1 home.
If I'm in the box right now, I'm coming unglued. He is going to throw something over the heart of the plate.
Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. And that pitch misses for ball 4. So the Giants have themselves a man aboard with 2 gone here.
The batter, number 7, second baseman, Donovan.
Next up, Donovan Solano, a base hit in his first trip. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. Hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd, foul.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
Fastball, and ooh, that ran in and drilled him.
Well, the good news is this guy can really dial it up and let it fly. The bad news is sometimes he overthrows it and has absolutely no idea where it's going. He's in a little bit of a trouble, so we'll see if he can work his way out of this.
In now, Steven Duggar. Now this pitch is lined into left center field. That's a base hit. Tack on another here as the runner scores from second.
Nothing fires me up more than watching a hitter take what a pitcher gives him. Pitches away, batter's able to keep his hands inside, not try and do too much, and just force feed a single.
Stepping in now, Alex Wood. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
Well, his guys just gifted him with a 2-out RBI, and now he's got a chance to help himself, too.
And it's fouled away. Struck him out, his 7th of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Giants will have to be content with just the 1. just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth, and that'll bring up the big bat of Max Muncy. The 2-1 takes a pitch for strike number two. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2. Chris Taylor is on deck. Into the corner and slicing foul. Payoff pitch one more time. This is lifted out to left. Dickerson is right there as he puts it away. No problem for the first out.
The batter, number three.
One gone now in the Dodger fourth. And in to hit next, it'll be the ever versatile Chris Taylor. Here now the 2-2. Just hung in there on that one. 3-1 is our score here in inning number four. Swing and a miss. Looked like the knuckle curve there, and that's out number two.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
At the plate now, Gavin Lux. And this is taken low for ball four, and they'll have themselves a two-out base runner here after all.
I know one thing. He earned that free pass right there. He was tempted with some really good pitches, but he stayed disciplined and drew the walk.
Now to the plate, A.J. Pollock. He's 0-for-1 thus far. And now they've got him picked off. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Dodgers go down quietly. They still trail it here 3-1. Garrett Clevenger, a 6'1" southpaw, will be the one that gets the call from the bullpen here. So in now for San Francisco, Lamont Wade. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
And this is taken in just shy of the warning track for out number one. Had a long way to go to make that running catch. And here it is again with the show track numbers. Took a great angle at it, showed nice closing speed, and ended up running close to 110 feet to finally bring it in. No doubt in efforts his teammates are appreciative of. Into the box, Mike Yastrzemski. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two. Now the 2-1. Yanked on the ground down the line. And he'll step on first himself for the out. So the bases are empty with two gone now, and that'll bring up the former World Series champ, MVP, and Rookie of the Year, Buster Posey. And it's two balls and two strikes now. That ball's headed for the gap in left center. He's got a base hit, possibly more. This'll kick up against the wall now. the relay, and he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
Their own pitcher is absolutely dealing right now, so this is a big moment in this game. If his teammates can pick him up and drive him in now, that might be all they need to get the W here.
At the plate, Alex Dickerson. Hit in the air to left field. Pollock has a read on it. And that ends the inning. So they can't make anything out of the two-out double. More ahead from Dodger Stadium right after this. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and up next, the center fielder A.J. Pollock. And he fouls this one off. Again, a 1-2. To two balls and two strikes now. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Here now the 2-2. Popped him up. Posey over to his left. And that's the first out of the inning. Albert Pujols will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. One-one misses for the second ball. 3-1 our score as we play inning number five. This for the second baseman Solano. And the throw is wide as it pulls the first baseman off the bag.
This is a head scratcher. I mean, that's the shortest throw on the infield, and somehow he lets it sail wide of the mark for an E4. Couple more like that, and doubt starts to creep into the second baseman's mind.
Now here's the Giants skipper making his way out toward the mound, and he's going to motion for his bullpen here. That'll do it for the starter tonight. So he'll head to the dugout after working just 4 1/3, not enough to qualify for the victory, as his bullpen will have to go a long way to hang on to the lead. Number 43 is on, and he'll take over on the mound in relief.
Number 43.
Standing in now, Mookie Betts. Breaking ball swung on in the dirt.
I think that's one of the toughest calls for an umpire to make. The check swing appeal, hitters rarely feel like they went, and I don't think he likes getting rung up there by the first base umpire. But looking at it, it's hard to say for sure that he didn't go around.
A 1-1. Now a shot out toward the alley in right center. Pujols blows through the stop sign, headed for home. Safe at the plate. And the deficit is down to only one now.
Great piece of hitting here. Man on first, and they're playing him to pull, but he crosses them up and goes the other way with it, making the outfielder cover a lot of extra ground. That allowed the runner to come all the way around from first to score, and that was a great piece of hitting.
So now to the plate, Cody Bellinger. Good take there to lay off the high fastball. Too high that time, and it's 3-1.
They know the threat this guy poses at the plate. I know it's a 3-1 in this situation right here, but I cannot believe for the life of me this pitcher is going to come anywhere near the middle of the zone.
Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. And that misses, ball four, so it's first and second now with two out.
The batter, the catcher.
Here now is Will Smith. The base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Turner at second, Bellinger on at first with two down. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Dickerson's under it. He's got it to end the inning as they'll strand the tying run in scoring position. Dodgers get one in the inning on the RBI double. We're through five innings here tonight. It's now a 3-2 ball game. Joe Kelly takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring up the left-handed hitting shortstop and San Francisco Bay Area native Brandon Crawford. Down the first baseline, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. And now a pitch on the way. Swing and a ball hit on the ground. Staying alive, putting together a really good at bat here. Another foul ball, and this battle will continue. And this is swung on and missed as Crawford is set down on strikes, one away.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and it backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
To the plate now, Wilmer Flores, high in the air down the right field line, and that will end up a foul ball. Here comes the 1-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
In now, Donovan Solano. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2. Now the Dodgers get a right-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. 3-2 is our score here in inning number six. Good battle. Count remains full. Trying to strike out the side. Here it is. And he loses him on a breaking ball.
Up next to the Giants, the center fielder. Steven
into the box. Steven Duggar singled home a run in his last time up. Three runs, five hits, and two errors to this point for San Francisco. And a knuckle curve missed that time, 2-1.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
And he misses again, ball three.
good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
He's set. Here's the 3-1. And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls.
Now batting. Number 43.
Tyro Estrada will start to loosen up in the on-deck circle as he'll bat with two on and two out here. Two and two.
That pitch looked like it could have been a little high, but he's been calling that pitch all night. Kind of rough for a pinch hitter, but I'm sure his teammates let him know that's where the zone has been.
He's set. The 2-2.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Two men are on with two men out. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And the two-out threat won't pay off. The inning is over. Giants leave a couple. They're up 3-2. Harleen Garcia enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth. Now into the box, Max Muncy. His prior history in this matchup, not a big sample size, 0-1. The 2-1.
That's ball three.
Great situation right here, leading off the inning. You gotta find a way to get on base any way possible. But I don't like to take the aggression away from hitters. If it's in your zone, I want you swinging.
Popped him up. But this one lands out of play into the visitor's dugout. Now the 3-2 pitch. Lifted out towards straightaway center field. Duggar's there for it. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. Now with the plate is Chris Taylor. 0-1 for him here in this one. Two runs on two hits. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. Oh, forget about this one. Ba-ba-booey. Gone into the home bullpen for a home run. Chris Taylor with a solo shot, and the Dodgers have come back to tie it at 3.
Yep. This is why you just can't rely on one pitch. These are the best hitters in the world. And when they know what's coming, they're going to jump all over it, just like he did there.
Into the box, Gavin Lux. Now the fastball is swung on and missed.
When I broke into the league, not many guys were throwing that elevated fastball with that much velocity on it. The game has changed.
Here comes the 1-2. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Fouled away. The 2-2 one more time, and he bunched him up a bit as this is lined softly over first, and that finds the outfield grass for a base hit. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
That was not a good pitch, but he handled it nicely, guys.
Yeah, and the pitcher's got to wonder what he has to do to get it past this guy. That pitch was off the plate, but he showed great reach, gets good extension, and drives it for a two-bagger.
Into the box now, A.J. Pollard fouled off. The 3-2 pitch. Swung on and chopped toward the hole. And there's out number two. Zach McKinstry will look to provide a little two-out thunder off the bench as he'll hit with a runner at second and two away. The set and the 1-1. Oh, high, deep. That is a moonshot, folks. A long home run. So a two-run homer down the line in right field, and it's now 5-3.
Another excellent swing right there. That's multiple home runs in the same inning. Watch yourself. You're missing over the heart of the plate.
John Grebbia, a 6'1" right-hander, will be the one to get the call from the bullpen here. Standing in now, Mookie Betts. 2-1 now to Mookie.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Fastball is looked at for strike two. Hard hit at third. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
Little ground ball with eyes right there. He might have been a little bit out in front, but now I don't care. That's a bullet knock in the box score tomorrow morning.
Carver.
At the plate, Justin Turner. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Whoa, not sure where that one missed, and I'm not sure the pitcher does either.
Three runs already home here. Throw over to first, but the runner's back easily. Now the 2-1 pitch takes a pass and misses. That's strike two. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. Solano will put this one away and the side is retired. So three runs on four hits, no errors and a man left on. We're through six full. The Dodgers lead it 5-3. Scott Alexander is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven. Seventh inning ready to roll, and next in will be Wade Lamont Jr. Sent out to straightaway center field. Center fielder giving chase. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. The right fielder. Mike Yastrzemski digging in at the plate. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Bases are empty, one man out.
Now a fastball runs inside and drills him. Oh, that's gotta hurt.
Well, they say beggars can't be choosers. And when you're losing, you can't always choose how you get on base, but you've got to get on any way that you can. So he'll take that, even though it probably hurts a little bit.
So now to the plate, Buster Posey. Fooled pretty badly there as he reaches to poke this one foul. Another 1-2 delivery. And a fastball blew it right by him, and they're two down.
In a double play situation, you kind of expect most pitches to be down in the zone, hoping for a ground ball. So that was an interesting pitch selection to go up in the zone. I think he caught him off guard a little bit.
To the plate now, Alex Dickerson. And he misses 2-1. Yastrzemski, the runner at first with two gone. And it's two balls and two strikes now. So a full count now.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Strike three called as he can't get the bat off his shoulders. Side retired. Giants leave one. Still a two-run deficit. It's 5-3. So now into the box is Cody Bellinger. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
Well, I have to give credit to him on the mound for not letting that previous pitch get to him. He wanted it, but he didn't get the call. Catcher. But I love how he didn't let it affect him, and he comes right back with another good pitch and gets the punch out.
In now, Will Smith. Ball four.
Perfect.
Well, he walked him on five pitches, but that last pitch was really good. He missed down, but only by a hair. When a hitter has a 3-1 count, he can wait until he gets a pitch he loves.
So a runner at first now with one away, and that'll bring up the left-handed hitter Max Muncy. A 1-1. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
The batter,
Chris Taylor, will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here, a solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. The 2-1.
Nope, that's the ball.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
And a good at bat that time as he lays off for ball four, and as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
Shortstop, Gavin.
The batter will be Gavin Lux. Now the 3-2 pitch is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Dodgers strand a couple as they hang on to their 5-3 lead. Blake Treinen has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Brandon Crawford will dig in again, and as he does, we'll flash you back to inning number two as you get a look at his two-run homer that was a big blow early on. ball and two strikes now. The 1-2. And this is swung on and missed as Crawford is set down on strikes, one away.
Well, I'm glad we get another look at that beauty of a pitch right there. You can't spot a sinker in a better location because even if you do get the bat on the ball, there's not a whole lot you can do with that. Textbook sinker.
Into the box now, Wilmer Flores. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. And it's another K. So back-to-back strikeout victims to start this relief outing.
Now batting.
So now to the plate, Donovan Solano, career against Blake Treinen. He's a .333 hitter. Bases are empty here with two men out. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1. The count now at 2-2. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. Giants down in order. They're still down 5-3. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Dominic Leone will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Austin Slater is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and that'll bring up A.J. Pollock. And ooh, that strike zone's getting a little inconsistent now. It's 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, a crucial count for both pitcher and hitter. So, Dan, what was your approach on the mound in that count? Do you still pitch for the strikeout here?
Action pitch right here, 2-2. The last thing you want to do is to fall behind the count 3-2.
Flores is there for it. He's got it one away. Matt Beatty will come on as a pinch hitter to try and make an impact with one away. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
One thing that could nag at you as a pitcher is having to work really hard to get a guy that you think you should be able to cruise right through. He's not known for his offensive prowess, but he's putting together a real nice at-bat here.
The 3-1. And this ball is crushed deep down the right field line. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul, so a missed opportunity there.
Ah, man, just a hair early on that one and just pulled it foul. He's going to have to find a way to refocus. Not easy to continue an AB after you just went deep foul.
And that'll take care of the pinch hitter here for out number 2.
Now
back to the top of the Dodgers order. Digging in, Mookie Betts singled in his last at-bat. The 2-1. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Dickerson's on the move, and a great diving effort there, but it'll just tip off his glove, and it's a base hit.
The batter, the third baseman, Justin Scherzer.
Standing in now, Justin Turner. Hard hit ball to second. And nothing will come with a two-out double as the inning is over. One left for L.A., and it remains 5-3. Kenley Jansen takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door. All set to start the 9th in this one, and next to bat will be the outfielder, Steven Duggar.
Looking for base runners here as they're down 2 playing on the road. Not an easy thing to do, trying to score runs or bunch hits together off of a closer.
1-2 now. And that one misses badly. It's ball 2. And a swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the 9th.
When your closer comes in and strikes out the first guy he faces, everyone on the team can kind of take a deep breath. Still have 2 more outs to get. But retiring that leadoff guy is always huge when you're trying to shut a game down.
1 out, nobody on. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
Hey, that was a nasty pitch right there. Ton of rotation on that ball. You could almost see the red dot from up here. Nasty depth.
High in the air down the right field line. And no one will track it down. And it's fouled away. Hit the other way out toward right field. On the move is Betts. He makes the play. Really had to hustle to get to that one. 2 gone now.
The first baseman.
And now back to the leadoff spot in the Giants lineup. Stepping forward, Lamont Wade. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. 2 out here in the 9th. Shot back up the middle. And a clean base hit, so he gets off the schneid, as they say, and is now 1-for-5 in the game. So the top of the 9th keeps a rolling as he comes through with 2 away.
That base hit was screaming off the bat, and our ShowTrack technology more than confirms it. 111 miles an hour was the exit velocity of that line drive.
Stepping in now, Mike Yastrzemski. And this is swung on and missed. So now they find themselves down to their final strike tonight.
Man, you don't see this in today's game that much. A guy who's willing to work east-west consistently with a great cutter two-seamer combo.
Throw on to second for the force, and the ball game is over.
Well, folks, that's what Kenley Jansen does. When he enters the game, the hopes of the other team, they usually just leave. Slams the door again right here.
And this evening's contest comes to a close. 5-3 the final. The Dodgers rode an important 6th inning to victory in this one. Joe Kelly gets the W on the mound. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Here now is our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Dodgers, 5 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 9 runners.